Alright, hello everybody. Let's see here. It's going to be finishing up my Superman drawing today. We'll be doing some painting here. And you know what? Dang it, I forgot my watercolor tin. Hold on, let me get some music on for you guys. I'll be right back. Okay, guys, I'll be right back. Let me put that in the, Okay. Let me go grab my paint tin. This downstairs real quick. Okay, I'm back. I got my tin right here. Let me do something on my computer real quick here because my computer always has like this glitch or something where the sound always gets messed up. There we go. Okay, so let's start putting down some colors here on everything. We'll do the get the shadows put down and all that. And then we'll start doing the kind of move this up just a bit so you can see my. Let me go to Twitch too. I gotta change something on my Twitch stream. There we go. Just kind of put that off to the side just there, and just because I want you guys to be able to at least see me do the paints or whatever. got the... Yeah, let's just start getting some shadow stuff mixed up for the shadows here. So we got... So we got a viewer. Welcome. If you're having a nice day. Color mixed up here. All right, so let's kind of test this out. All right, so let's start on Superman here. Just kind of lay out his shadows. Light is coming from right here, so we need to do the light source properly. Then we'll also go over with like a darker blue over the shadows just to kind of, you know, in different colors just to make them kind of work them in a little bit more. Go up to the head and do that. He's got some shadowing going on here on his neck and in his hair. Just a little bit of so it's almost gonna look like a black and white. Well, it is already black and white, but it's gonna look, yeah, have a grayscale effect to it before I start layering the colors in. So a little bit of detail around there. Move my color around here so you guys can really see where I'm pulling my color from. Okay. Let's see here. All right, and then let's so the bottom of his feet here are going to be obviously shadowed. Let's do some shadowing on John here. He's going to kind of be covered up by his dad, so thank you.
Alright. So do the shadows here on the ground. Just checking my stream to make sure it was still going. Alright. Mixing up my colors a little bit more here. Okay, let's go over to the, we'll go over to the car right here and this old Ford. Here on the ground. Okay. Alright. Shadows, some more shadows on them. So since the light's kind of coming this way, this part of the whole cave's probably going to be real shadowed in. Alright. I think that's okay for now on the Alright, I think what we could do now is just kind of mix up the colors and start. I don't know if I'll do like all the skin tones on this. I might do just a base. So let's start with the... let's just paint Superman and John. So he'd have, this is gonna be a... yeah, this would be a good color for him. Just do a nice blue. some water to this. All right. There we go. This doesn't look bad. Let me pull up my reference here for John Kent to make sure, because I know he's got like a two-tone costume or something. So let me pull up my reference for him that I got on the computer. Notice that his nose goes up a little bit too much. So actually, let me fix that real quick. Let me get my pencil out and just see if we can, what that'll look like. Okay, yeah, because in that way it doesn't look like his forehead's all weird. There we go. All right. Got the two-tones. Let's just do the blue on Superman real quick. There we go. There's still... Okay, and down here. Thank you. Alright, there's the blue. Oh. This part of his arm right here. Smoothing this all out here. There we go. His jeans are probably going to be the same color here. Alright. Okay. I'll go back to my other reference picture here. Make some of these other, you can make like their scrubs that they're wearing blue. Thank you. Alright. Alright. Then, let's see what else we got here. This will actually work really good for a sky color. This is a water on there just to kind of blend. Yeah, there we go. Alright, so hold on, I'm gonna get my water brush pen here and just kinda get some of this right here and just kinda So I want this to all kind of blend up because I'm doing like a sunset, so. Risky. Be okay if I get this down before I do any of the other harsher colors, so that way it's that way I could just paint over them if I make any mistakes. All right. Okay. All right. I think we got all the blues down. So I think we could probably do the yellows now. Before I do, because if I do, I want to do the yellows first before I do the red, so that way it doesn't bleed or pick up any other colors. Mix up a nice yellow color here. Hey, you know what? I forgot to do the flag. The flag, yeah, red, white, and blue. Hold on. It's actually gonna actually want a little bit of black in the blue to darken it up a little bit. Yeah, actually, I could use the. That'll work. And hold on. I want to add some more blue to the background here. Alright, so let's do flag real quick on here. There we go. And then he's got a darker blue right here. And then right here. And we'll do his sleeves in like a darker blue. could probably take some of this. This is a darker blue. You know, we'll add some more black to it is what we'll do. We'll just kind of... This will be like the night sky up here. Blend all this together. Don't worry, this is all, I want to do some really bright yellows and pinks over this background here. This is just kind of to darken some of it up. So a little tab of pink here. I think that's good. Let's see here. Oh yeah, we're gonna do the yellows. So mix up some nice yellows here. lot of yellows because I'll do the. I'm gonna do the cornfield or the wheat field back here and everything. So this is a good base yellow to start with, though. Start here with his S. Oh, that's gonna be way too saturated, this brush, so. That is yellow now. Let's go to the John here. Bright yellow, let's do the sun here. Here we'll just kind of blend it all together out here into the uh, Alright. I'm gonna do the glow on Superman right here. Probably have to go over the red again with a little bit more yellow after, just to do the... and his skin, just to get the glow down. Okay. So let's do... oh, we still got some more yellows to do, so let's... I mean, darken up this yellow with a little bit of... burnt umber colors, or whatever it's called. Alright, this will be a good color for the landscape back here. Nice. We could also do this lady's hair too in that color, so I'm gonna have to scoot this over just a bit, just to alright. And what else are we gonna do here? Actually, this, we could paint this color too. Alright. I guess we could do the red on Superman and John. How's this red? I'll go with this one up here. This one's better. I guess let's just try this one. Yeah, this one will be fine. Not going to need too much red for this one, just the boots and the, Okay, that looks like enough. All right, let's start. We'll start with the trunks here. Alright. Get down to the boots now. Alright, and then the cape. Thank you. S, both the S symbols are going to be the hardest part. Because I don't have a very small brush, I'm just kind of using the tip here to really to do the whole thing, so. All right, not bad. You're Jonathan now. Stripes on the flag here. see where else we can use this red at. I can't really see anywhere else where we would. Let's see here. Probably gonna be time to do the skin tones. So let's hold on here. Forgot to do the lines on the street. We'll get those done real quick. To be too fancy because they're all kind of dingy. Kind of just, there we go. All right, so now let's do the, we'll do the skin tones. Mix up some skin tone color. That's enough of the skin tone color to kind of start out right now. All right, so let's, there we go. Alright. All right, let's do the skin tone of a I'll do these three, and then I'll mix up some darker skin tone for these two people down here. We're just gonna do flat colors for the mural. Kind of adding a second layer on here just to really I might have to add another layer of the skin tones after I do everything else. It's really, really light. It's not saturated at all. Alright. Okay, so let me just finish the mural off here, and then you know what? I'm gonna mix up add something darker to this skin tone here, just to kind of there we go. That's better. Settled a bit more of the skin tone to it. We're gonna have to go over this again here. One more layer. See if that makes a difference. Oh yeah, that makes a difference. Alright. The skin tone's much better. Alright. You fix her eye just a bit here. Okay, so now we got the skin tone mixed up. I want to do a little bit of a tanner one for him. So we'll add... I'm going to add a little bit of brown to it. Just a bit, nothing too much. Add a little bit of the other tone that I used to darken this up. A little bit more brown. Yep, that should be good. Let me see. Yep. Okay. We have to paint her lips, so we'll just do kind of the... Alright. Mix up some more brown for her skin skin tone. Alright. Just don't want this to get too oversaturated or anything. Kind of work some of this color around here so that way I don't doesn't pull up or anything like that. All right. Also use the same brown tone for her. Camo uniform here. All right. And we'll use this color here for her other camo stuff. Okay. So let's, I already have these colors here, so let's mix them up. Now we'll do the ground. Okay. Alright, so I got the path in here. What else can we do here? Let me reactivate this gray color here. I'm gonna use that for the sidewalk here. All right. little bit of black to this. Just a bit. And some more water, and we'll do the street. The grass. I'll do a nice forest green for the grass. It seems like a nice color. Alright. All Then let's see here. I think we'll do. Let's color the building real quick. Or wait a minute, hold on. Let's color Soups's hair. Oops, shit. Yellow after to, oh dang, to really get the sun going on the I'll probably go over this with some go over their hair with some markers again to make it darker. Mix up some red with this brown, and then we'll just go from there. Yeah, almost a brick red color. That looks good. Okay, what else we got here? Well, we're actually getting close here. paint this guy's hair. Oops. Nope. There we go. Saved it. There we go. There we go. That don't look bad. Let's do like a wash in the background of them. And then I think we could just do the sunset and then the car here. And I think we'll actually be done. I'll just do a few more light highlights here and there. Here, I forgot to do the... saturated. Alright, so let that absorb into the paper. So let's do a nice like a light lavender kinda. Reuse some of this color under the sunset. So let's do... some pinks going here, some like really light colors here. Let's just add a little bit of reds to this one here, so there we go, kind of brighten it up a little bit. Let's see what we got here. Oops, no. All right, get some water on here and just kind of work it all into the... Let's add some more reds to this one here. Orange red color here. Let's move this over here because I don't want to risk dripping anything on the parts of my drawing. Thank you. Alright. Let's go over this with a... Just get my water pen here, and we're just gonna kind of blend some of this together here. Kind of work all this around here and make a nice... I know I got it in the speech bubble a little bit. I'm gonna have to white out some of it. There's a few areas here where I'm gonna have to do that. Just kinda, I don't really get rid of this line here. I think we're pretty much done here. I just need to just do the, add some paint to the car here. We'll do this, the car in pink. Do a little bit of yellow highlights here. Oops, shoot. Why am I getting all on here? So overbearing here. A little bit right here too, and then just, there we go. Tops here. Do a little bit of a just a little bit of a wash over some of the stuff here, just to really kind of like the light kind of coming in behind them. A little bit on the street here. Especially like this here is going to kind of have a little bit of a kind of convey the light. Kind of hitting the side of the building here. Just get a little bit of the water pen right here and just kind of actually, it looks okay, I think. I think we're just about done. Let's see here. Let me get my whiteout out. We'll correct a few of the little places where the paint bled outside the lines. Just to help it out a little bit. We'll do the stars. Okay. Let's do a little bit of the right there, just to make it look a little bit. So I usually do white where the sun is, so. Use one of my crappy brushes so that way I don't like risk getting any of the white out in it and ruining my good brush. Alright. Watercolor pencils here and just kind of do a few little doohickeys here and there to really cover up a few mistakes here and there. Actually, I think we're going to go over that with a brush. Or something just to alright. I think we're all good, so I think I'm gonna probably sign this right now then. So we'll just say, just wanna say thank you for watching, everybody. This was really fun to do. Thank you. P1. We're already there. Alright, everybody. We'll be back again with some more streams. Probably tomorrow. I don't know what I'm going to do. Do something fun. I'm going to start planning my next drawing, whatever that'll be. But yeah, I appreciate you guys who've watched me go through with this ever since my I started doing the sketching stage. So hopefully, you know, you guys will, I can get some footage of my next planning session for whatever drawing I choose to do next. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I will...